COVID battle cannot be won by doctors of my age. No war can be fought by people of my age. You need young people. From PPE and ventilator, we shifted to oxygen. And the next headline in the next few weeks is going to be patients are dying in ICU because there are no nurses and doctors to take care of the patients. And this is going to happen. I have no doubt about it. For every patient who's tested positive, there are minimum of 5 to 10 people who are positive, but they are not tested. That means we are talking about at least over 15 to 20 lakh people who are getting infected every day in our large country. 5% of the COVID positive patients need ICU bed, irrespective of their age. That means we need to have at least 80,000 new ICU beds daily. Many of you may not know, India has only 75,000 to 90,000 ICU beds, and all of them are packed already, and COVID has not reached the peak yet. Now, what we need to do? We need to create at least 5 lakh additional ICU beds in the next few weeks. Unfortunately, beds do not treat patients. We need nurses, doctors, and paramedics in that order. The real workers in managing COVID patients successfully in ICU are not the doctors, they are the nurses. Now, we need to produce at least 2 lakh nurses and at least 1.5 lakh doctors in the next few weeks who are dedicated to manage COVID for the next 1 year. Now, how do we produce 2 lakh nurses and 1.5 lakh doctors to manage COVID ICUs for the next 1 year? If there is one country which can produce that workforce in few weeks, is India. No other country in the world can do this miracle. We have about 2,20,000 nurses who have finished their 3-year GNM or 4-year of BSc in various nursing schools and colleges across the country, who are preparing in the library for their exam, which should happen in the next few weeks. If the Ministry of Health, along with India Nursing Council, take the approach of drafting for the armed forces when there is an impending war with the enemy country, these girls should be told, all right, you have finished your training. You haven't finished the formality of exam. You're all graduates. You'll be given a certificate. But you are given a certificate at the end of 1 year if you work in a COVID ICU for 1 year. Apart from that, if there is a government job coming up, all the girls and boys, nurses who have worked in this COVID ICU for 1 year should be given a preference over the rest. If that is done, I am convinced most of these girls and boys will join the stream of a fight against COVID. Now, what about the doctors? There are 1,30,000 young doctors working not in the COVID ICU. They're sitting in the library, mugging the multiple choice questions to crack the NEET exam to get one of those elusive PG seats. The National Medical Commission should, along with the National Board of Examination, should conduct online test for NEET right away without any delay and declare the results in few days. And there are only about 35,000 PG seats available. Allot the seats. After the allotment, there will be still 1 lakh doctors, young doctors, who are left out, who didn't get the PG seat. They should be offered a huge grace mark during the next year of PG selection if they work in the COVID ICU for 1 year. If we are able to do this successfully in the next few weeks, believe me, we would have conquered the COVID battle. Otherwise, the consequences can be very, very, very serious.